Hello everyone, my name is Minty and welcome back to The Sims 4, and it has been a little bit since I've had some, you know, consistent videos on the channel. I'll probably talk about that a little bit later, but before I really talk too much about myself and all of that stuff that probably a lot of you don't care about whatsoever, I am going to talk about the house. So today I decided that I was going to build a starter house, but I wanted to kind of have my own little sets of rules, I guess, for building the starter house. The main thing is I just wanted it to be a cute little starter house that didn't necessarily feel like it was a starter house. A lot of the EA starter houses, especially the ones that came with the base game, they are dark, they have really awkward lighting, they're not cute, and they typically are just way too big and then don't have the budget to really fill in the space, so they end up just not using the space very well at all. So I wanted to keep this small. I wanted to make this a reasonable size, but also be a house that I could definitely see easily being expanded upon. I think there's certainly room to eventually have a second floor if that was something that you wanted to do, to add more bedrooms to. I feel like this worked out to be a house that your Sims could really grow in, and I think it's quite cute. I think I accomplished that part of it. I don't necessarily think it looks like a starter house, and even after, when your Sims move into the lot and then place this house down, my Sims still had about 1,500 simoleons or so, so it's not going to spend all of your Sims starting money either, which is really nice because, yeah, it's great to have, you know, a 20k house, but then if your Sims don't have any simoleons left over to really get them going with anything, I don't really like that idea. So I wanted to make sure that there was enough in the house for your Sims to get going, but also not just use all of their budget that they have, so that they have a little bit of wiggle room to play around with. The other thing that I really wanted to make sure this house had was a computer, because I feel like if there's any object that is essential to basically every Sim, it's a PC, because they almost need it for just about anything to do in the game. So I really wanted to make sure that your Sims had a PC at the ready. It's not a great PC, it's the cheapest PC, but it is a PC. The other thing too is that I did end up using very cheap appliances. They are the cheapest appliances and the cheapest counters and pretty much all the cheap furniture. But my thought is, well, you can at least have a fridge and a stove and everything. And later on, once you get more money, you could certainly upgrade the kitchen. Maybe if your Sim is handy, you could do some upgrades on these cheap appliances. It's more or less just a place to get your Sims started that doesn't look horrible. That was the idea. But I'm really quite happy with what I was able to accomplish, I guess. I think it's cute. I could definitely see myself playing in this house, which is very rare because my mindset is anyone else on the gallery has made something better than what I could probably come up with, so I'll just use someone else's build instead of playing in my own builds. So I was quite happy with this. I couldn't really decide on a color scheme for this house. Originally, I was thinking blue and orange were going to be the primary colors in the house, and you'll see the sofa and the fireplace in the living space changed half a dozen times because I couldn't decide. I ended up with a very just beige and blue color scheme in the end. Not my favorite, just having everything quite beige. I do like a lot of color, but I think it worked. It works for the swatches that we have on a lot of the cheaper furnitures, because honestly, a lot of the swatches that are on the cheap couch and on the cheap fireplace are just like, they're just not cute. They're just not realistic to me, especially some of the fireplace colors are quite strange. So I think going for blue and beige ended up working, I suppose. The other thing, I would have liked to fit a shower and tub combo in the washroom, but it only ended up with a shower. But you know, I'll settle for it. I think for a Sim just starting out, just having a shower works, and then eventually, if your Sim's going to be having children, or if they're going to be having a dog or something that they require a bathtub, then you probably have enough simoleons at that point that you could upgrade that washroom and make it a little bit bigger and fit a shower and tub combo. But I just went with the shower. But the house itself, it's pretty basic. You've got one bedroom. The bedroom is quite on the feminine side. Not necessarily my intention. That's just how it kind of ended up. But I always figure that if you're going to be downloading a house off the gallery, the first thing that you're probably going to change is the bedroom and kind of customize it and make it fit your sim. I also didn't want to decorate this house too much, but I didn't want to not have any decorations either. So I did put a couple things on the walls. There's some plants here and there, but for the most part, I figured that if you're going to use this house similar to the bedroom, you're going to put up your own decorations and you're probably going to add items and objects that your Sims get through career rewards and through events and all of that. So I wanted the house to be decorated. I didn't want it to be cluttered. I'm also just not a big fan myself of having houses that are too cluttered. I like some clutter. I like Sims houses that feel like they're lived in, but I don't like just things everywhere. I kind of, you know, I like having spaces that are clean, that feel nice, that feel lived in to a point, but not too over the top cluttered and messy. So I think I accomplished what I wanted. Obviously, I would have liked to use some nicer furniture, but for just using the cheap furniture, I think it came out okay. I'm happy with it. I really liked kind of the challenge of making a starter home. I think that was really fun, and it didn't feel like a challenge that was too overwhelming since I was only using the base game, and it sort of made me want to try making more starter houses in other styles. I think the main problem with that, however, is that once you got into other styles, it would be very difficult to keep under the budget, because I mean, if you wanted to make like a Victorian starter house, a lot of the furniture that you would want to use would just end up being way too expensive. Because I also thought about making a grandma starter. If you're new to the channel, hello, I love my grandma style. But I think, again, most of the objects that I would want to use for like a grandma starter would probably be too expensive. But maybe it's something I could try. I kind of want to make more starter houses now. I like the challenge, the mini challenge of making starter houses that aren't too starter house-ish. And I don't know, maybe we'll see. Maybe I will make more starter houses. But that's pretty much it for the house. So if you have been following the channel, thank you, by the way. I do really, really appreciate all of your comments. I love reading them. I love responding to them. I love the fact that anyone is interested in watching my silly little videos at all. It means the world to me. So thank you. I don't think I say it enough or can really say it enough, but I do really appreciate it. I haven't been very consistent with my videos lately. I'm very aware of that, and it's been kind of a point of some stress, I guess, for me, is just the fact that I constantly feel like I want to do more and I can do more, but I'm just not doing it, and it's definitely disappointing for me, disappointing in myself, and I keep wanting to do better, and I keep, you know, saying I'm gonna do better, and then I feel like I don't do better. So I really want to make it my goal to do better. I think a big part of that is just motivation. I definitely have felt a lack of motivation lately. And to be honest, I really haven't been playing The Sims, like even in free time. I haven't been feeling it. But with Snowy Escape coming up, which by the way, if you missed it, I made a little reaction observation, I guess, video of the Snowy Escape trailer. That was the most recent video that I did on my channel. But I am so excited for Snowy Escape. I cannot wait to get my hands on it. So I think that's going to definitely help propel some of that motivation for me and hopefully get more videos on the channel. But I did just want to give you guys a little bit of update, especially if you've been following the channel and you've left some lovely, lovely comments. I do really appreciate it. I want to do more for you guys. I really do. But that is it for my little starter house. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. If you're interested in this house, you can download it off the gallery. My origin ID is a MintyBot, or you can also search the hashtag MintyGames. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked this video, go ahead and leave a like, comment up below. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. I do normally post Sims videos weekly, so I will see you all next time. Bye, guys!